We'll call this meeting of Bedford Charter Township to order. We'd all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Sally, were you recording? So who's recording this?
She's gonna. It's not coming out.
Yeah. Is it powered on?
The other side's powered. I'm just trying to get power with it. There it is, it's coming out.
I'm the tech guy.
Okay, we're good.
Does it say recording then?
Yep.
Timer's going?
Yep.
All right, sounds good. So who's doing the roll calls tonight? Is that?
I will.
Thank you.
Ready?
Yeah, roll calls.
Hi, Cliff.
Here.
Bracco's excused. Dazatell here. Sipsey?
Here.
Shaw?
Here.
Gibson?
Here.
Johnson?
Here.
We have a quorum.
We have the approval of the February 2009 minutes. All right.
That's great.
We can do that.
I'm just gonna keep track of that for.
We had a motion. Well, I guess I so move and then support, so.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, not a problem.
You jumped again a little bit, that's all right. So, call the roll on that.
Bracco's excused. Dazatell, yes. Sipsey?
Yes.
Shaw?
Yes.
Gibson?
Yes.
Johnson?
Yes.
Heikla?
Yes. All right, so.
Motion passed.
Motion passed, yes. Thank you. So as you see now, next up on the agenda, we have the supervisor's address. Oh, I do apologize. We did have.
That's okay.
You would actually, I didn't see you guys had come in. I do apologize. We did have another request to open us in prayer, so I guess if we would all stand again, we will pray. Sir.
John, please lead in prayer.
This is Pastor Robertson of Bethel Baptist Church. And we need God to help our protection. Heavenly Father, Lord, the Bible says, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask of God to give them all men liberally. And these are our leaders. And we need you to give them wisdom. Our country has changed much since I was a little boy. There's more violence, more poverty, more everything than there was when I was a little boy. We ask you, God, to please watch over our law enforcement. Two more policemen were shot in Detroit today. It's a sad thing in our nation. Our leaders don't seem to be leading us down the right path. I ask you, God, to protect the law enforcement people here in this county, in the city, in our state, and across this nation, Lord. And I do beg you, God, to give the township representatives here, these members, the people who have been elected duly by our system, wisdom to make decisions that would be in benefit of our township, this county, and would help us. We pray, God, that they would follow you. Our nation seems to have left your path, and we need your help, God. So I ask God to please be in this meeting. Please be in each heart and mind. Help us to think of the whole and not of the person, God. And everybody makes a sacrifice, Lord. Everybody puts in their part, Lord, this nation be better. Be a nation of givers, not takers. So, Lord, we ask you again, Lord, for your direction. And please help these people, Lord. They're responsible for the population of this township and this town. We ask you, Single in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
So now we're on to, I'd like to do every month an address. I would like to share with you all things that I've been working on, as well as ways that we've been improving, and different projects that we have in the township. I feel that over this last month, as I said last month, we continue as a board to communicate better. We continue to work better together, and I'm very thankful for all of that. We all have expressed to you, the residents, that we want to represent you to the best of our abilities. And that is why we were elected here. And I'm truly seeing out of all of the board members that, that is what we want to do. And that is what they all would like to do as well. And I think that I speak for everyone when I do say that. So I just want to thank everyone for the continued working with me and learning about me and with some of the different ways that I do things than the previous supervisor. This month we've had because of the delay in the meeting, we had our board of review meetings. It was a good time for me to learn a lot about our township, about a lot of the properties on our township, the assessments that are going on, why you have the taxable values and the assessed values that you have. And if you guys have any questions about any of that that's happening, I would ask that you reach out to myself or John Foltz is the chairman of that board, and I know that he would love to share with anyone information as far as what the Board of Review did this week. As I mentioned, there's some changes on the agenda. One of the changes that you'll see on page 2 is that we do have a section for introduction of ordinances. I want to make sure that we are introducing our ordinances in the proper fashion. By law, by MCL code 4220, we are required to present those ordinances and give you time as residents so that you can participate and you can ask questions about those ordinances and changes that we will be making. And so we will have that every month. So keep an eye on that. Those are the important things that we will be doing that possibly could affect you. We are doing all the steps that we can to continue increasing our transparency with you, the residents, and increase your ability to participate and guide the way that our township is functioning. This past week, obviously, we had a pretty big mess in the township and across the entire state with this windstorm. I think that we all on the board agree that there's some things that we need to look at as far as maybe some of our emergency plans, as well as we are looking into power sources for the Fire Station 2 as well as Fire Station 3. I did have someone come in from a company to spec out our needs for this location, as well as Fire Station 3, so that in the event of a power failure, that we do have some backup energy. In that process, I did realize that investigating the possibility of going to some solar options might make sense if we are going to spend the money to look at generators. I feel that it's warranted to reach out to some different groups to see what our possibilities would be to do some green type technologies where we're at. At the end of last meeting, I had mentioned that we do have an epidemic going on, something outside of Bedford, but really does affect Bedford that I personally have been working on, is an event that's coming up next Tuesday. It is called the Battle Creek Battle Against Heroin. And I would ask all of you here to come out to the event. It's going to be downtown Battle Creek. It is at 5 to 7 p.m. And it's a rally to bring to light in our community ways that we can come together and fight the addiction problems that we are all facing. Because I think everyone in this room can think of someone that has been greatly affected by the problem of heroin. And it is something that has touched me very deeply. I want to see these changes happen in our community, guys. And so for the last week, that is something that has really been my focus. So I have been in and out quite a bit the last week, working on making this an opportunity to make and spark some change within our community. That is all I have for now, for this month. Again, I ask any of you here that want to learn more about me and who I am and my passions to make this entire community better, I ask that you contact me, schedule the time to sit down with me, and I will discuss with you and show you who I am. And I thank you again for all those that have reached out, because again, several of you have, and I hope that that number grows every month. So thank you for that, guys. And now we're going to go on to the special order of business. Resolution 3-16-17-12, resolved by the Charter Township of Bedford to adopt a change to the payment of trustee pay to the first pay of each month rather than semi-annually. I so move.
Board.
Okay. Is there discussion? No? Pretty much discussed it last month. We're good? Yeah. Okay.
Call the roll.
Call the roll.
Desitel, yes. Sipsey?
Yes.
Shaw?
Yes.
Gibson?
Yes.
Johnson?
Yes.
Heikkilä?
Yes.
Brock was excused. Motion carried.
Motion carried. Communications. These communications are things now that we have in our packets. Majority of this information we are going to be making available to you on the website. And so anything that you see that's going to be under that section, you will be able to find via our website, or if you would like a copy of any of this information, please come to us and we will provide that for you as well. I saw a look from you, Sally. Was there something there that you think we should go over? That's a little different, so I want to make sure that we're covering all that.
I think it's all set.
You think that's all set? Okay.
I would like to know what does check register mean?
Mm-hmm. Check register?
Oh, it's just the
oh.
Yeah, so it's just our yeah
just
check
the
register.
Payment.
We do the payments that we did. Correct.
Those are going to be on the website. So all this stuff is going to be on the website, is what you're saying?
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. It's. I'll show you how it's going to be. It's going to be all in one packet. So. Number eight here, we have the introduction of the new ordinances. And I'll just go through. This is a brief synopsis. Again, there's a lot more information in these ordinances. And if you'd like a complete copy, you can reach out to us and we will give you a copy, as well as you can go to the website and have this information as well. So the sanitary sewage disposal system, an ordinance to provide the operation of the sanitary sewage disposal system within Bedford Charter Township, to prescribe the rates to be charged for the use of said system, to provide for the mandatory connection to said system, to repeal all prior ordinances concerning the sanitary sewage disposal system, and to otherwise protect the public health, safety, and general welfare. The ordinance B on the list is sanitary sewage disposal system rates. Resolution to approve the sanitary sewer rates for Bedford Charter Township as outlined in the attached schedule and which will be incorporated into the sanitary sewage disposal system ordinance described above. Letter C is repeal the former Planning Commission resolution. So we will be repealing the resolution from 11-9-0037, Township Planning Commission. Subsequently, we will pass the new language as noted below. And so D is the Planning Commission description to meet current MCL 125.3811 guidelines. This is an ordinance to describe the powers and duties of the Charter Township of Bedford's Planning Commission, to describe membership of the Planning Commission, terms of office and vacancies, to otherwise comply with the 2008 PA 33 concerning the responsibilities of Planning Commissions, and to protect the public health, safety, and general welfare. We'll move on to number nine, reports. Do we have any finance reports?
Just the resolution.
Just the resolution for the payments?
Yep.
Okay. You want me to just go through all of them? I can do that. Resolution 3-16-17-13, resolved by the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Bedford to approve payment of expenses totaling $265,423.96. I so move.
Support.
Any discussion, guys? Any questions? No? No?
Okay.
Call roll.
Sipsick?
Yes.
Shaw?
Yes.
Gibson?
Yes.
Johnson?
Yes.
Heikkilä?
Yes.
Baraco's excused. Azatol, yes. Motion carries.
Public health and safety.
Good evening, everyone.
How are you doing, sir?
Sergeant Hugg, Battlefield Police. I'm here with Lieutenant Fernando. His last deployment with our wonderful department. He'll be leaving sometime soon. And with Officer Barton. There's been a changing of the guard here for you. You fine folks. Sad to say, Officer Kilborn is still with us, but he's on the night shift, so he's going to be watching over you while you're sleeping. Therefore, Officer Barton was groomed and chosen to come out and try and help us out with delivering messages that we bring to you every month. I'm just going to touch on the one thing that Officer Kilborn had handed over to me. There was a question about fines and traffic tickets. He was able to email Joanne Green, who's the traffic supervisor of the Tenth District Court. This is in reference to specifically the funds that come down and how they're distributed or dispersed throughout the county. She sent me a sheet. It doesn't specifically have the funds, but it does have an explanation of different traffic violations and how the fines are distributed. But to summarize the question that she had, or that you had clearly, that the court sends the funds, they're distributed to the county clerk and to the county entity as a government. They are then distributed out to each of the entities within the county, so Bedford Township would receive a check from them. I still don't have a solid number, as that would obviously be a line item for each individual month. You know, it's a very small amount, say $100. $100 would be broken down, and once everybody has it in the pot, we may be looking at $1 to $5, maybe 10 if it's a serious fine. So we're not looking at a surmountable number of digits here, so that you can fix an entire roadway or maybe pay for some of the floor, but it could be something that could be used in the near future for your budgeting and for, I think that's a great idea with solar power. Any other questions in reference to that? If not, this is Officer Barton, and he's going to talk to you a few minutes about the foot patrols. Yes.
Is this a new procedure? Because since I've been here as treasurer, the township has never received any funds.
Okay. Not that I know of. As far as I know, this is how the wheels have been turning since they began. So this would obviously be a question.
So maybe we have a large check ready?
And say, okay, specifically.
No, I think the police contact specifically says that it goes to the police department with your attorney for the tickets, and we don't get anything.
Okay.
I think it's in the contract.
I've not seen it in the contract that we share in those funds. So that, I think, if anything, that's possibly why. But if there's a large check, we are definitely going to, we'll track it down.
Yeah, I can try and dig in a little more and get my fingers in and get a specific thing. We'll go through the contract and then find out directly why or why not. Maybe that's something that you want to try and work on with this next contract coming up, saying at least a part of the distribution to go to the township. Why not?
Right. Sure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yep, welcome.
Sudi.
Like Sergeant Tuck said, I'm Officer Barton with Battlefield Police Department. For all three of you, just to call me Alex. I've been with the department for about 2.5 years now, so still learning every day. I know I got some big shoes to fill from what I hear about Officer Kilborn, so please take it easy on me, just a couple weeks or so. This is my first time in Bedford, so I get my feet wet. I'm learning everything still, so what I ask from you guys is just a little bit of patience. Feel free to come up with me whenever you want. If you can, I'll leave a couple business cards, get in contact with you with any questions you have. As far as questions here, I'll field them as best as I can. I'm not going to sit here and tell you that I know everything, so I might not be able to give you an answer right now, but when I can, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. What I have in front of me is the stats and kind of trends for the month of February. Nothing too much that stands out. There were a couple games on the Baskin Washington Park. Two of those were kind of back to back. There's a couple large games too. Try by the same person since the both of them on Bainsville were from Larson and Peterson. So that's my book. What I ask from you guys is that now that the weather's getting nice and stuff now, people tend to keep their cars on lock, windows down a little bit. Just make sure you lock those up. I can't tell you how many times when I go to a call and I see something and I say, how'd they get in? Because the windows are something like that. But just make sure you lock your cars up. They leave it unlocked. And unfortunately now, when it's getting warm up, it's a friend of opportunity. There's more people on foot. They're going to see that GPS sitting there. They're going to see that loose change. So, like I said, if you guys have any questions, feel free to come up later. If you don't want to ask me from everyone, ask me now, whatever's best for you guys.
Do you carry, or does the department carry, this heroin anecdote, you know, over
the Narcan? Yes.
You have that?
Yes, we do. We have a little, I believe it's by notes now.
Okay.
Close to the notes. But the way what they're mixing it with the carfentanil and everything. You want this shot, doesn't do anything. I've heard someone get really the hit 8 times before they get that.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Follow up on the medication with Narcan. You said a presentation with a kids' school at Norwood this past week. And anybody that's interested in getting it, whether because you may know somebody that has a problem, they just have it with you, just fall for it since anything goes down. Any of the family fairs, if you go there, you go up to the pharmacy and tell them you want it, they provide it for free if you take their training. It doesn't have to be police, fire, or paramedics. They will provide it to anybody that will sit through the training and give you free. And the question is, what if I get somebody that doesn't need it, say they just squirt water if they want it. If they don't need it, it doesn't hurt them.
Okay. That's good to know.
It won't turn out what's going on if they're not on the opiate, but it won't hurt them. But family care says they'll give it out for free to go through the training.
Okay. Anyone else right now?
Thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah, you could add some numbers and next month, I'll be the heroin depending on
that. Okay, as far as what I've seen in the month of February, I don't see anything with overdoses. I don't know if I can. Yeah, I don't see anything on here right now for overdoses. I can see
it. I don't want to pass back for you.
Yeah.
But.
I can go back and see if my computer pulls up anything up on that. But like I said, what I have for me right now, I don't have any overdose. And I know I've only done our appointment just started at the beginning of the week, and I haven't
So are you on patrol all year in Victor County?
Yes, I am, from 2 p.m. to 10 p.m.
Okay.
Yep. So on the afternoon shift, and then Officer Bradley is morning shift, 6 p.m. to 2 p.m., and then Officer Coburn is 10 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thank you, guys.
Officer, since you're new to the neighborhood, we really like our officers that give nice warnings.
Oh, warning?
As long as you hand them your trusty card, is it?
No.
Everyone here for sure. That's right.
Nice warning.
Scott, just so you know, I did reach out just today, actually, and was asking for those statistics specifically for Bedford Township. So I've reached out to four different locations, and we should have that. So if you want to reach out to me, I should have something on that real soon as well. So, okay. Yeah, I can. I'll be sharing some more of that in the next weeks as well. So, okay. Thank you, guys. Up to Chief. How you doing, sir?
Well, I'll make sure we don't have double rebuttal here. Last month, since we've been the month last meeting here, we have run 68 runs in the township here. 14 runs of that was mutual aid. We went down to Climax with the big harvester right on the four corners, that rester down there. We took the tower down there. They called us a little later. They should have called us a little earlier, but we took the tower down there and set that up and sprayed water on the top of it and put it out pretty fast for them, a lot faster than they would have got it themselves and stuff. So I think the building was pretty well damaged. I think they don't believe that they're going to rebuild it back. I haven't heard any more about it or stuff, but it was destroyed, and they got started by a electric heater in a downstairs apartment or something. Some of the other mutual aids we went with Penfield, with Pines over there. We've been called a few times over there because of smoke in the hallways or something, burnt food, so we had no big fires going over there. Biggest runs were last Wednesday. You know what last Wednesday was? When the winds come through here, we made 32 runs that day, starting at 9:30 in the morning roughly, and it was probably 8:30, 9 o'clock time we got back home to buy us and stuff. Trees down, wires down in the roads, power lines were down. We have primary lines that were snapped right off of the pole up there at the arms and stuff, they land in the middle of the road. We had to take a lot of them off because we cannot sit on them and wait all day for consumers because they were anywhere from 3 to 10 hours behind coming on some of them areas and stuff. We had a lot of big trees down, a lot of big pine trees down. The wind just blew them and snapped them right off, right up there on Gilrich by Saddle Ridge. We had a big old pine tree that was laying completely across the road. A lot of limbs down and stuff, so we were pretty busy last Wednesday, and every year it seems to be we have a day or two that we get a lot of storms that come through here and stuff, and we're out all day long on wires down and trees down, but you'd think by now a lot of them limbs would be pretty well stiff enough up in there, but you can see what that wind did Wednesday, and that was only 50, 60 mile an hour winds. I think about 100, 120 mile an hour winds, what would happen to a lot of places around here and stuff. Hopefully we never have that. Some shingles got blew off of some houses, some of them, the roof up there on 37, the old restaurant there, it's just past Meacham, they had a tin roof on the back of that. That got folded right up and laid right over in the front of the place. So you can see, that was a pretty powerful wind and stuff. And they did lose power. They're out here for 2 days on power at the station here and stuff, and a lot of people are out longer than that. But that was a busy day for us. The pancake breakfast had to have been changed till May 13th instead of the 20th. So make sure you pick up a folder out here, stuff. More information will be coming onto that later, but the 13th of May is when we plan to have it right here. I'm going to be making to the board a proposal for next month on the paying system on the probation people that are going to school in it now. They're coming up the end of this month, I believe it is. They'll be taking their test for the state to pass their written test, the physical test. They complete that, they will get a certificate that they can start working on working fires and stuff like that. They will be certified to do it. In the past, here recently, there's 240 hours that they have to do schooling. They do this on a computer. Every couple of weeks, they meet at different stations with a couple of our men, the captains here, to go through what they've been going over under the computer so that they are sure they know what they're doing before the exam comes on up. Those 240 hours, we pay them for going to this school and doing this and stuff. It can add up just a little bit of money, and in the past, we paid them the full amount. Sometimes they'll stick with us maybe 6 months, maybe a year, maybe 2 years they get out of them, then they go someplace else. What my proposal is going to be is go back and pay them one third each year of that pay, that 240 hours, so we can keep them for 3 years. If they go within the 3 year period, good deal. Well, they forfeit the 2 years of the pay if they decide to go in 1 year and stuff like that. Instead of paying them $2,000 for a up sum, and then they bail out in 6 months from us. See, we've trained them. They went hired in a different department. That's a no-go. I don't like that idea. I want to keep them here for 3 years. So by this way, the proposal will say, hey, you're going to get paid one time this year. Next year, you get the other third. 3 years, you'll end up having the full amount. So
this is what I'm going to propose to the board. We'll see which way it goes. We used to do it a few years ago, and then for some reason it got changed back to giving them the full amount. I don't like that idea. Just for your information, how much it costs to put a firefighter up in here and to train them, 240 hours to get certified, how much you got invested in each one of your firefighters here at this township. It costs $6,224 per person, roughly. That's gear, complete setup, 240 hours of training. You times that times, we got 26 people here in the department. That's quite a bit of money you got invested in the fire department right here in the township on people alone. But gear, they have to have safety stuff. Stuff gets bad, we've got to replace it. Stuff is not cheap anymore. It's getting expensive. I've got a set of bunkers and coat I'd like to have. One of the guys bring you tonight to do stuff that we are ordering up and let you look at it. Just for these two items right here, it's costing us $1,806. That's not including your boots, helmets, gloves and stuff. So you can see this gear, it's a lot lighter. And if Bill, I could tell you a little bit about it, and I can go right ahead and explain to you.
So this is a new technology. We bought six sets of gear to test this out. Our turnout gear has a 10-year lifespan. So every 10 years, you're supposed to replace that. We've got about three more years on our gear, so we're trying this out to see how well this works out. This is a newer technology. It's lighter weight. It's supposed to allow us to breathe better, our bodies to breathe better. It has a lot of nice features in it. So far, I like it. It's very comfortable. It's very maneuverable. It's the best as far as range of motion goes that I've ever used in 30 some odd years. But like Chief said, $800 for these, $1,000 for this, and that's just this. Then the helmets are another few hundred dollars.
And about $300.
Yeah.
Helmets, boots are over $300.
Right. So an ensemble with everything you need, gloves and everything, you're close to $3,000 just in this stuff here. So it's not getting any cheaper. But these things here have a nice, they got these padded channels in here. It's supposed to help get your body heat away from you, give you air channels in there. But so far, the evaluation is everybody likes them so far. But you're welcome to grab hold. This is a clean pair of pants. They've not been issued yet. So this is my coat. It's got a little bit of grunge on it. I'll leave them on a chair here.
We have, take a look at them. We have wrote a federal grant to outfit the entire department. It costs $78,000. Our portion will be 5% of that. So we should find out anywhere, well, from now till about June, whether we get awarded that grant. So we are actively looking for other ways to help pay for that stuff. But that grant currently, we should hear any time whether we get that federal grant or not.
Excellent.
That would cover all of the firefighters?
It will outfit everyone in the department.
Mm-hmm. And that includes from helmets to boots.
Okay.
So it would be a big savings if we can, because otherwise we're looking at a big chunk of money to boot up the other 20 people on the department. I can't do it. Not on our budget I got now, unless I come in with some more money someplace to raise it up there. So grants out for the gear. We have a grant out for new hoses, and we also have a grant out there for our department for three of the new automatic chest compressions that's out there where it can be set up with what, less than a minute?
Yep.
Of setting them on up, and an automatic battery operator does a chest compression up onto the people. So if that grant goes through, then we'll have three of them in this department in here that we can use and stuff. So hopefully the grants will go through.
Chief, and those machines are $14,000 a piece, and again, our cost is only 5%. Yes.
So you can see we're moving along, and it does cost us and stuff, and we have, a good bunch of people around here on our department and stuff. The boys are just about two of their training, the four, and they will be taking the exam here pretty soon, in a few weeks, and hopefully they all pass it and stuff. And that will give us four more young men that hopefully will stick around with us for quite a while and stuff. And it would be great to use them. Most of them right now, the last bunch we had, and this bunch here seems to be eagerly a bunch of people that to replace some of us down the period of time that we'll be going and stuff. So, if you have any other questions about anything, I'd try to answer them. If not, pick up that folder on the 13th, and then if you care to wish Mr. Matt Doty a happy birthday, it's his birthday.
Happy birthday, Matt.
Chief, I think there was one question there. Yeah. Chief, did you have
it? I am.
Oh, no, you just waved him? Okay. I saw a hand waving. I'm sorry. I thought it was to get your attention. That's all. So, thank you.
How old are you?
70.
Oh, yeah. That's so I didn't picture myself, but man, he's pretty handsome.
All right, so moving on, we've got buildings and grounds. I saw Kevin. I don't know if Kevin had any updates on with the windstorm, anything cool to report.
Trees went down. We got a huge one that's going to get taken care of tomorrow.
Yeah, did you get that figured out then with the
about
in the cemetery?
80-year-old tree. Yeah.
Yeah, was it? Okay.
Took a few markers with it.
Yes. Yeah. Cool. All right. Thank you, sir. Legislative and intergovernmental relations. I don't think Frisbee or anyone else was here that I saw. So yeah, okay. And unfinished business. We've got the Planning Commission appointments. So we have Resolution 3-16-17-14, resolved by the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Bedford to appoint the following members to the Planning Commission, along with the following terms: Joseph Sipsick. Our trustee is going to be on the board until the end of his term in 2020. We've got Mr. Barry Beamish. He's going to serve from today until the end of 2019, 12/31. And Susan Morgan is, again, with Mr. Beamish, is going to serve all the way until December 31st of 2019. I so move. Support. Any discussion?
I have discussion. Mm-hmm. It was my understanding that you were going to share with us everybody that applied.
Okay.
And that never happened.
Okay.
That would have been helpful for us to know that.
Okay.
Also, I guess I would like to know the people that are being replaced, did any of those apply for the position?
They did.
Okay. And so, well, I don't see their names here, so.
Correct.
You decided against someone that was already on the board that had experience and knowledge.
Correct. We are here to make some new things happen in Bedford Township, and that happens generally when you have new individuals involved.
Is Susan Morgan here tonight?
Susan Morgan actually runs a Celebrate Recovery program, and that has been running for several years on Thursday night. And so she would love to participate within our township. She has been a longtime member of our township, and so she had reached out. She has a lot of community planning, and so she has a lot of valuable assets to bring to the Planning Commission. So.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So would you care to share with us what you based your decision on who you picked, or?
Yeah, I went off of Mr. Beamish reached out to me, and we sat down, we had lunch, and we discussed his passions. He's actually been a fairly regular member attending our meetings, and so he's shown that he wants to be involved. Our discussions that we had showed that he is passionate as I am to make some really positive changes happen here in Bedford Township. The other members that I was alerted by, and I did say that I will get you guys the information. I'm sorry I didn't get it before the meeting tonight. The other members, I went through the list and I looked at the names that were on the list. I knew several of the names that were on the list, and there are people that have been on different boards or even the Planning Commission previously. One gentleman had a lot of credentials. I did not feel like reaching out to the gentleman because he is very deeply rooted with the city of Battle Creek. And I think that we as Bedford Township need to focus on people that are going to be serious about Bedford Township and not have any political ties or other connections that might tear away from us focusing on Bedford Township. Susan Morgan was actually the very first person to apply for the position. And so I had reached out to her right away, and I knew that it would be a good fit for the Planning Commission. So.
Okay, I have one last question. So is it your intention that when everybody's expiration date comes up that you replace them?
That is not the intention. If it is someone that maybe is not going to be a good fit, then it is what it is. We need new changes here in Bedford Township. And so I see nothing wrong with adding some new faces to some of these boards. So. Any other comments? No? Take roll call.
Shaw.
Yes.
Gibson.
Yes.
Johnson.
Yes. Yes.
Heichel.
Yes.
Rocco's excused. Dazzletel. Yes. I guess. Sepsic.
Yes. Any carries? Thank you. On to new business and petitions. Resolution 3, 16, 17, 15. Resolved by the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Bedford to change the regular office hours to Monday through Thursday, 7:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. We will close from 12 to 12:30 for lunch. And this is to allow residents additional hours of operation for us. Offices will be closed on Fridays. New hours will be in effect March 20th, 2017. I so move.
Support.
Is there any discussion?
Sorry to call.
Support is a discussion, then it's tabled. Yeah. So we'll, any questions
just to let
on that?
I know we did do a lot of talking about this, the trustees and the girls in the office. There was several of you that came in that couldn't get here at 4 o'clock, so we kind of stretched the hours on that. They cut their lunch hours short. And not to say that I don't want to speak for Chris, but Chris is pretty conscientious about her job. And not to say that there may be some extended hour during tax time capacity.
No, on days that I have to be here, it might fall on a Friday, I'll be here.
Yeah.
Just looking up next year, I think this is a good fit for everyone. It'll give these folks a little extra time to have a long weekend this summer, and I think it'll work out well. If anybody in the audience has any questions or any problems with it, I'm sure if you contact the girls, they'll be more than happy to work with you on special appointments if you can't get here on a certain time. So they're pretty flexible, and they really will work well on the schedule. Thank you.
Goes for me too, not just the girls. So.
Yeah.
Anyone else on that? No? Take roll call then.
Gibson.
Yes.
Johnson.
Yes.
Heichel.
Yes.
Rocco's excused. Dazzletel, yes. Sipsic?
Yes.
Shaw?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Now we have Resolution 3, 16, 17, 16. Resolved by the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Bedford to support our 911 fees being added as a surcharge to cell phone users in Calhoun County and be put to a vote in the next countywide election. I so move.
Four.
Discussion on that, guys? You want to explain? You want me to explain that?
Could you tell us about some of the details you have on that?
Sure, yeah. 911 fees, a lot of residents are unaware at the extreme burden on municipalities, the 911 fees are. I believe the numbers that I saw for the last 3 years, we range from $75,000 to $125,000 a year that the township incurs for 911 calls from cell phones within our district. A few years, I think it was 3 years ago, was it, that was up for a vote in the county? Was that Sandra?
Right.
Yeah, about 3 years ago, it was put to a countywide vote. This is to add a small surcharge to all cell phones within the county. So this spreads the burden from municipalities, and it's a very minimal it's a minimal increase for folks as far as your cell phone bills are concerned. It's going to range the way that it's going to go on until they calculate exactly what it would have to be. It could be upwards of, I believe, $2.30. And that would be a monthly on just cell phones. Now, this isn't for your landline phones. Now, this isn't something that we are approving today. What this is just so that we can go to the county, and the county then is going to collect from all of the municipalities and see if there's enough support for that to go onto the ballot going forward next year. But some of that planning to make that happen has to begin now. And so I know that we were in support, the board was, I believe, before when that went onto the ballot, because it's going to free up upwards of $100,000 a year for us to use for things like the fire department, for, you know, just some of these other things that we need to really be a little bit more efficient upon. And so I felt that it was something that I know I could support. Many of the other groups are all in support as well. And so, like I said, this is just to get that ball rolling. So. Is there any other question?
Was that just for countywide?
This would go. This would set it across the entire county, correct? And so we're going to be in contact with all the other townships, as well as, you know, the city of Battle Creek, with Albion, Springfield, and so.
So then not only some kind of spreads out more equitably, not just on the landowners.
Exactly.
Everybody's got
an address
in the
exactly. 100%.
And
exactly, and it's a far less burden. You know, if we were to raise a millage, it's going to increase all of your taxes by a much larger sum. So, yes, Matt.
So currently, the way it works, so everybody knows, for instance, we have a fire call for whatever reason, we incur that roughly $21.
Right.
If we need police assistance, that's another $21. If we need a tow truck, that's another $21. If it's a medical, that's another $21. So one, if we need mutual aid from another department, if they phone out Penfield to come help us, or Johnstown, they make that phone call to Johnstown, that's another $21 that they're charging us. These call for utilities, gas companies, the power company, they just charge us all the time for those. So one call could cost us up to $200, just insurance surcharges that we're paying the 911 center.
Right.
And it can get you down. City of Battle Creek, I can't imagine what their bill is.
Yes.
It's in the hundreds of thousands of dollars, not close to a million.
I know I'm a township, but it's about 220.
Pennfield Township, Bedford Township, the city of Battle Creek pretty much pays for the entire county in surcharges just because of our population. There are some townships that don't pay a dime for this, and it's not fair to us. It's not fair to us as residents to have to flip the bill for other communities or townships that have 2,000 or 3,000 people. And that's what we're doing. So one call, just in surcharges alone, don't count our wages or their wages or anything else.
Right.
If one call could generate just an extra $200 just for 911 pushing a button and talking on the radio. You know, so that's something that we should seriously look at.
Right.
You know, so that's kind of how this went when the 911 millage or the phone millage didn't pass the last time. Mm-hmm. They decided this is how they're going to fund their 911 center. So, it's something seriously to look at. And overall, it will save us all a lot of money. I know we don't like to pay extra taxes on our phones, but that's currently the system we're in right now. So we are actually get bitten a lot more than we should.
Yes,
I know you said it's just the beginning savings, but you're not always going to apply, because that's the way that I can pay. My phone, my wife's phone, and two children are going to have emergency. Versus somebody that lives by themselves that has, you know, 30.
Right.
I mean, how are they going to apply it to the phone?
Right. It is a it is a per line basis now, and that when it goes through the county, they have a way that they, you know, through AT&T, through the different providers, that surcharge would be added. I don't know those exact details yet, but that is something that the county then will be added on then to those plans. So it's a per line, correct?
So. And I don't believe that the government issued phones will apply to that either.
Yeah, I do not believe
that. That last time when it went out, it didn't
correct.
Apply to government.
However, that's getting taken care of. Will probably be brought up in that, but yeah.
Will
so
continue to be okay. Taken care of.
Correct. Yes, ma'am.
This is not
the correct. This is for the cell phones. Correct.
Mm-hmm. If we're giving them $200,000 a year from the township to the 911, why are we being charged $21 every time we use it?
Right. Well, no, that's the total. Like I said, it's ranged anywhere from about $75,000, I believe, like in 15, and then in 14 it was like $125,000. Like I said, it's varied, just because, like he said, it could be different every call. I think it usually averages about $50 a call, though, is what it ends up for sure costing us. Right. So. Is it? Yeah.
Well. Was it? I know there's towers in another township, but the 911 center utilizes our property up in the village of Bedford for one of their transmitters.
True. Something else to look into, right?
Yeah. Something that maybe if they're going to flip us a $200,000 bill, we had 2% of that sent back to them.
Right, right.
You know, they probably will say. But, I mean, that's something to consider, trying to recoup some of the money that way.
Right.
I mean, I don't know how other governmental entities are doing it.
Right.
So. I know at one point in time that they had free use of that building for the transmitter.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay.
Something to look at.
Absolutely. Thank you. Anything else? Can we roll call?
Okay. Let me just figure out where I'm at. Okay. Johnson?
Yes.
Michaela?
Yes.
Caracos excused. Desitil, yes. Sipsick?
Yes.
Shaw?
Yes.
Gibson?
Yes.
Motion carries.
All right, on to resolution 3-16-17-17. This is resolved by the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Bedford to accept the interlocal service agreement between the City of Battle Creek and Bedford Charter Township for fleet services. I so move.
Support.
Question.
Discussion? Yes, sir.
This is existing or this is new? And does it encompass, in other words, the fire trucks, Kevin's truck, other equipment, what have you, everything that we have to be done at the field services?
What this is allowing is the City of Battle Creek has a certified mechanic to do the repairs on our fire equipment. You have to have specialized training to work on that equipment, and the City of Battle Creek now has someone locally that we can go to. From my understanding, it can save us a lot of time and a lot of money now to have a local person service our vehicles. And so what this is saying is that legally we are able to now utilize those services. It's not saying that we have to use those services. If we have somewhere else that we have to go, we are able to do that still. But this is just the agreement that allows us to utilize some local repair services for our specialized equipment. And he can, Mr. Bill here can fill us in a little bit more on that as well. So
where this came from is we've taken our fire equipment down to the City Equipment Center for several years because they have certified people to work on it. It's local. We get a good turnaround. Basically, they charge us for labor, and pretty much that's about it. Something came up down the road with some of their mechanics and some of their training, and it came out that, hey, we don't have a piece of paper, we don't have an agreement. So through their risk management, they wanted to have basically a whole harmless agreement that if we use them, we're not going to come back and sue them if something is, you know, something broke or whatever. So this is something that we've done in the past. The city's risk management wanted a document signed that just said, in exchange for this, we'll do that. And it's fairly basic. Short of having this agreement, we essentially have to send our equipment to Shalott, to Spartan Motors, and we pay a lot of money for the manufacturer to do the work. They do great work. That's what they do. That's what they specialize in. But when we send things to Shalott, it goes away for 2, 3, 5 days. It doesn't get turned around as quickly as it does when we go down to Battle Creek. So,
Bill, we've been doing that right along, though, right?
Yes. Yeah. It's just we had a cease and desist from their risk management department.
Because we didn't have an agreement.
Because, and now City of Springfield has signed this agreement, and a couple other municipalities are signing the document.
Okay.
So it's kind of just like a dotting the I's and crossing the T's.
Well,
so
it's a protection for them in case something happens.
Right.
So,
well,
and in us in some ways as well.
Right.
Absolutely.
It's a two-way street at that. You know, there is immunity between municipalities unless there's gross negligence.
Yes.
You know, municipalities are not really going after each other for things like that. You know, like I said, if they forget to put the lug nuts on a tire and you drive down the road, it comes off. Well, that's gross negligence, and none of the paperwork matters at that point. But, you know, it's just a simple, for lack of a better term, a whole harmless agreement that in exchange for their services, we will provide money. You know, and it's not an exclusive contract. If we need to, we can take it anywhere else, or if they're busy, they can say, we don't have time to work on your stuff right now.
But we've been doing it and getting a pretty decent deal for for going through that.
Yeah,
until we were cut off.
Thank you.
All right, so I get that. My question's answered, so maybe let me say it a different way. What I'm asking is, before I vote, is this contract, I understand the fire department's interest, and I have a problem with what you're saying. What I'm asking you, if we go into a contract and sign it, is it going to encompass all of our equipment out here that would be utilized at the?
I don't think so.
Well, then why wouldn't we think of that, though? Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't we? Well, where are you going to take Kevin's truck? Or are you going to take a plow? Or are you going to take?
Well, there's going to be. I think it's going
to
be. You know.
That's a question that could be posed to them. I don't think they would be necessarily opposed
right.
to working on Kevin's Bobcat or, you know, anything like that.
He normally has his work done at Steensma where it's been purchased. Talking
One
to
of
my
the
hands.
Things we wanted to try to do is the smaller, like the grass trucks, things that could be serviced by township residents, like Tri-State Automotive, keep those in the township as much as possible. To help give them, you know, help those guys out as well.
Shirt or something.
But the bigger trucks have to go to a certified fire truck mechanic, and that's why that agreement takes place. We wanted to keep it local. Two, they give us a better deal, and we got certified guys working on it. Smaller stuff, we want to try to keep local, keep business within the township.
Right. As far as Kevin's stuff goes, I mean, he can address it better personally, but. His equipment is covered with, he already has things in place that he takes his Bobcat to, and he takes his lawn equipment to, and he, you know, so.
He gets a better deal.
Well, you know.
That's what we're always looking for better, you know, we're looking to do the most efficient way possible.
Well, is it
We've
something
been
that they would be open
stuff,
to?
So,
I'm sure they would be open to it, but, you know,
his equipment's
if it's not broken,
pretty
don't fix it,
serviced by where
goes.
It was purchased
yes.
from.
Yes, and I know he gets a good deal on that.
Did that clarify?
Hopefully?
Okay. I'm going to roll call then. Thank you.
Oh. Get back to business. Heikkilä.
Yes.
Garfield's excused. Dazatel, yes. Sipsic.
Yes.
Shaw.
Yes.
Gibson.
Yes.
Johnson.
Yes. Already got it.
Motion carried.
Might do it again. Mm-hmm. To trustee personal privilege. Yeah, everybody's helping. Everybody.
Well, this is not a criticism, this is just an observation. I hear a lot of times we say MCL, MCL code, MCL code. But I would caution that before we, especially publicly, adopt governing our township by MCL codes, that we first make sure that coincides with the MTA Association guides that we already have in our own charter, because MCLs are in place as a guide, just like the county guide, that we must abide, that you can add to. So an example of what I'm talking about is if the MCL says you must have a dog on a leash. We in Bedford Township could say, well, we also want to have him on a leash in the yard, or fences on the yard also. So the MCL is the base. And I don't want things that we already have that's been working within our township and our municipality as a charter township, opposed to a general township, that if we just go by the MCL, something that we've been doing for the last 6-7 years takes away. Does everybody understand what I'm saying there?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So we can't just use MCL first. We look at MTA, what we've been doing, our best practices, what's worked for MTL guidelines. Then, if that isn't covered, then what we've been doing, then we put it back to MCL.
No point.
My turn?
Sure.
Okay, I want to speak on our meeting that we had for the fire station number one. The president was myself, Marty Ulrichs, Chief Copeland Spider, Bill Woodward, Alice Hill. I don't know if she's here or not. She always sits in the back of the room. And Mark Heyer. We had a lot of questions. Meeting lasted an hour and a half. Mark brought up several good points of the program and schematic designs. We spoke to the chief about the wish list of everybody's fire department. We're going to build the biggest and best there ever was. No, we're not. We're going to build a very, if we build, this is not going to be a recommendation from this committee to build or not build. This is going to be, here's what it's going to cost you, folks. Here's what it's going to do for you. And basically, that sounds simple until you get into, do you have living quarters there? Do you not? In the future, if you go and graduate from a volunteer fire department to, as this township grows and needs, some of the chief and some of the battalion chiefs and captains have spoke on, we may eventually end up with a full-time fire department of some sort. 1, 2, 3, 4 people, who knows? So if you're going to plan this for a 20, 30-year period, you plan for that and see what happens. There was some real good discussions on this. Mark kept us out of a lot of questionable things I didn't understand, which a lot of us are learning. It's a learning curve. He's got a lot of knowledge just because he's done it all his life. So he makes some very good suggestions on step-by-step. It's going to take about 4 months to put all this together. At that time, we'll have some of the board help me put this together and present it to a meeting of the entire township. We'll post that, let you know how that's going. It's going to be, regardless of if we go, just for food for thought in the future, it's going to be expensive. It's just the way it is. It's going to, our general fund budget is not going to handle something like this. We're spending money out of our general fund at a record speed right now. Yeah, we're gaining some back, hopefully, but just to keep up with what we're doing in the next year, you know, versus 5 years down the road for a new fire department, we're going to have to take some serious looks at that. So I will keep you all updated. Our next meeting is April 10th. So by then, we should have a lot more on paper. We think we have to do and how we're going to go about it. And so, like I said, this will not be a recommendation to do or not do. This is just a fact-finding mission of what we should have and what is probably going to cost us. And yes, go ahead.
Is it going to be where the old fire department is now, or are you looking at someplace else?
We're looking at both on that. We have the property up there. The chief has been good enough to give us the dimensions. We have about 216 feet of usable road frontage there. The old station has also been brought up by Adam as maybe making a historical land site if there's any grant money, but I'm not going into that. I'm just making you aware of that. That'll be another committee that I won't be serving on. I'm sure of it. This one will probably be plenty for me. For
so where
years.
Is the new one being proposed to be built?
The new one, we don't have any proposal on that yet. We do have the land there next to the old station. We have the ability to put that station in there. It'll be a three-door, probably, bay similar to this. But if there's other the Kirby Road and Bedford Road, M37, seems to be the center of the township. So we want to keep it as close to that center there as we can. If you buy new property, as we all know, property is very expensive. That piece of ground is looking pretty nice right now. As far as, we're going to go both ways. If we find a piece of property, whatever that cost is, that's the cost for a relocation.
So we do own the property that the township or the fire department sets up?
Yes, oh, absolutely. Yes. And as time goes on, we'll explore a lot of different avenues. So when and if this ever happens, everything will change. So everything's just as objective now, because every 3 to 5 years, we all know stuff changes. But this is something that we've needed to look at for many, many years. The building is, even at its worst day, it's still a good building for the trucks, for the new trucks. You cannot make the doors big enough to get a new truck in. The truck that's out there is quite old. Someday we're going to have to give that away and resurrect a new one. So there's no way you could put a new piece of equipment that you would buy today in the existing building. So that's why we're taking this look at this for down the road. Any more questions on that?
You say you want to rebuild there. Years ago, probably before you're here, we were told we could not build a fire department there because the ground was all contaminated from a gas leak.
That,
now, what area, is that just that one little creepy spot? Or?
That area, I've talked to. Yeah, let Chief speak on that.
That contamination was over on the north side of the station.
Hello.
Contamination was on the north side of the station where the gas tank was sitting, and a bump set there as you come in the driveway there by the Queen Church and the station there, back to the white building back there, Kevin's building, right on the corner. That's where the tank sat and it leaked. So the contamination, the gasoline and stuff all went down. It went over toward the church, underneath the church basement, through the driveway, started down towards the road, toward the creek over there. That's the only flow area that it came. The test wells have all been sealed up now. The whole deal, the environmental, has been paid off. We can build out the that part of the area we have, and I don't think we're going to have to worry about any contamination because the gasoline did not even go over that way. It went the other way. So that's something that they're going to have to check the ground and stuff. I know that many years ago there was a house built right over there. It was over there, an older home, and then it got tore down and all filled basement in and stuff. But that property is 88 feet wide and it's a little over 200 feet long. So a station can be built there like this, 87 feet long. And we are looking at putting in extra room and stuff because down the future that may end up, this area may end up being a full-time fire department. Who knows? But by then, probably a lot of us won't be around here. But this is what we're looking at this time. And it's going to take a while. It's going to take a lot of looking between everybody, figuring this and that out. And like I said, it's something that's not going to happen in 1, 2, 3 years. Money's out there, some grants for it to help build, and this is what we'll be looking at and stuff. Anywhere where we can save some money and not all of us have to pay extra money, taxes, that's great. But this is something. It's in the future, and it's going to have to happen. And that building is built in 1937, and it's had a lot of use. I can remember even having Christmas parties up in there and stuff many, many years ago. So right now it's in kind of bad shape. And like I say, we're married to that building right now. With those two trucks that are in there, we cannot get any bigger trucks. We cannot get any higher trucks than what's in there right now. So it needs some work, and it's going to cost if we do some of that. But I think personally, it's money we're going to be throwing down the drain. So that's why we're looking. Yeah, what we're doing right now at the future of new station. So, but I don't think you're going to find any contamination over there because everything went the other way. And that's supposed to be all cleared now. Over the years, 20, 30 years that we've paid the state, that you have paid and your taxes and stuff, paid the state for contamination and checking all them 20-some wells, a lot of money was paid for nothing. So I'll leave it at that.
Yeah, I believe it was cleared last
month. Anyway, I'll give you another report next month. Like I say, this is a fact-finding mission only, and we're going to leave this up to good residents of Bedford Township. And you can't build a facility like this without asking for the magic words. You're going to have to increase your taxes, folks, just to add that little icing on the cake. But we won't panic on that yet. We'll wait until that time gets here. Yes, sir.
So you're saying you want to raise our millage and all this stuff? No. Which is fine. But can't you wait till we got our road paid for?
Yes, sir.
You double
yes.
tax.
I'm saying years down the road.
We're on a fixed income.
Yes, I'm saying years down the road.
We're on a fixed income.
I'm just planting that seed. It'll take years for it to grow. I don't want you to panic. I'm not going to raise any taxes.
But I mean, you know. We got a road tax, now you want to put a fire department tax, blah, 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 not down the road. You want to update your equipment, which I understand.
By the time.
But we only have so much money.
That's true. I'm just not like that statement got here. We're going to raise the taxes. I just want to make you aware of that. It is not a build or not build. This is not my job to decide this. It's up to the citizens of the Bedford Township.
Right.
This is merely the recommendation. It's a fact-finding mission. That's all it is. I can't emphasize that enough.
Feasibility study, essentially, is what
yes.
we're doing.
Yes. Mm-hmm. All right.
Not to throw a clinker in your planning, but don't forget the cemetery. The maintenance building, you know, our office for the cemetery is bad. And it is our jewel in this township, that cemetery. We got to have a place for this equipment and also for the grieving people to come and look at the plants. Besides the fire department.
That also would be included probably in an office for Kevin, the records, and anything like that.
Yep.
It'll be just more than a fire department. Yes, thank you. Any more? Anyone else? Okay, one more thing, just for an update. On the medical runs, we're still putting some of that, some of those figures together. Not anybody's fault that we haven't voted on it yet. We just want to get it absolutely as close as we can and get it correct. The medical runs are still a priority for this board. We just, due to the fact of all the things that have happened, we haven't come to a dollar figure on that yet. Hopefully that'll be corrected by next month. So just an update on that. And that'll be something we're talking about within this next month to get it resolved. That's all I have. Thank you. No.
Anybody else?
Okay.
No. Good. And citizen time. Anyone?
I have a question.
Yes, sir.
You talked earlier about the ordinances being on the agenda and for the public so we can hear what these new ordinances are going to be. Are they going to be on the agenda so we could look on the internet possibly before the meeting?
Yes.
Because sometimes it takes some time to digest that before you have a true feeling on
yes.
the ordinance.
Absolutely. And that is. Do you have more?
Yeah, how long before the meeting would they be on the website?
Tomorrow I plan on trying to get everything that we've discussed here tonight, these ordinances, onto that website. So keep an eye out for that. And that is actually, when I said MCL code on that, that is actually, by law, we are required to present that to you at a meeting, and we're not allowed to approve or pass any of those ordinances until we have presented it to you. It cannot happen at the same meeting. Okay, and so that's what that MCL code stands for, and that is a law that is a requirement for all municipalities. And so that's why we will make sure we do it in that fashion. So yes, you will have it, and so keep an eye out. And like I said, if you wanted to get a copy or something, we could get you those right away as well. So,
okay.
Okay.
Then I got another question. Are we seeking grants for the solar or the generator for the emergency?
Yep, absolutely. That's another reason why to explore that opportunity, because there's tons of ways. A few people that I spoke to this week discussed ways that we can maximize our dollars because of rebates through Consumers Energy to get started in our increased efficiency. And then absolutely, there's a lot of different opportunities for green technologies to get grant funds or other rebates, other ways that will make that a very feasible option. And so that's why, as I said, I would like to explore that option definitely. So,
And I have another question.
It's not really supposed to be a question, Ed, but yeah, that's fine. That's
speaking of grants, I've heard of grants that the city has got and the county has got for blight.
Okay.
Have you ever just maybe thought about applying for a grant for blight in this township?
Yeah, well, I've had several residents that have reached out to me because we do have, we have some blight in our township, and people have wanted to find how they can help. You know, with all of these people coming to these meetings, I've been wanting you to reach out more so that we can form some of these different groups from the community to help to tackle some of these issues so that we can identify some of the areas so that we can start reaching out in a different manner and we can go after some of these things like these opportunities so that we can get some funds to help clean up some of the different areas. So I will definitely explore that. So. Okay. Mm-hmm.
I don't think he's done.
Speaking of blight, do you have a code compliance?
Yes.
Do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, the code compliance has typically been handled through the building and zoning department. We've had a blight officer that has helped us with that, and we've been taking complaints only. We haven't just driven the township looking for people. We've waited for a complaint. The class I just got back from on zoning says that's wrong. We should just be cruising the township looking for trouble. And we haven't done it. Quite honestly, some of the areas, if we did that, we'd have thousands of places to write up.
Right.
So I don't know that that's what we'll do, at least not in the short term. As we get going a little stronger on it, we might do more. But for now, it's on a complaint only.
Sally, he follows up on the complaint, but does he make the residents do anything? We
try to work with the resident and give them time. So I've got some people that have called me and said, hey, I can't get it done in 30 days. Can I have another 2 weeks, another whatever, because they got to get a dumpster set. And we try to work with them. And in some cases, I've got a written report from the homeowner telling me I will do this and this and this and this and this in this time frame so we know what they're working on. Some places, there's no way they can clean them up in 30 days.
Some places that don't clean them up even after you've been there.
Well, it isn't really good to take them to court either.
Yeah. That's why we're exploring every option right now, guys, because we all want to see this place beautified and changed. And I think coming together as a community to help address some of these is by far the best way to do that. So, yeah. Anybody else?
Well, I think we've got a big blight problem here. I know I've worked in the township a long time.
Yeah.
And I've had problems with my neighborhood, and we never got anything done until I got over 10 seconds. Mm-hmm. Then things started rolling, and I spoke to Tom, well, before you get that number, let's write the paper, we've got news calls.
Mm-hmm.
You know, well, we'll get some cooperation finding. Well, no, you're not doing nothing. You're not. Yeah, I know we have an ordinance. My personal feeling, you to follow through with it. I mean, it goes through two letters and a fine. And I was on it 2 years, and I know any fine we ever went to court with.
Oh, yeah.
That pushed aside.
You know? I know a fine we went to court with.
Yeah. I've taken a couple people to court, and the judge won't move.
But the ordinance needs to be changed after two letters, your butt's going to go to court.
Right.
And you're going to pay a fine.
When the court won't do anything, what do you do?
That's the problem. The judge will give them another 30 days, another 30 days, another 30 days. Next thing you know, it's 2 years later, and the judge still has not done anything. That's a problem you've got with the judges.
Yeah.
And all that's doing is costing you as residents.
Right. And that's why we're looking at alternate opportunities, guys. That's why I mean, let's get creative in some of this. Let's come together and be creative and figure out how, like I said, we can all make it better if we all put our heads together. So, yes.
You know, I mean, if we could get a grant, then the able-bodied people who are able-bodied, I mean, this mm-hmm. is a very old township,
mm-hmm.
and I think maybe a lot of people are choosing to live like pigs.
Sure.
I think you choose to do heroin. I think you choose to do drugs.
Sure.
But I think some people are not able-bodied enough. And
absolutely.
So we as residents, why don't we help those people out if we can get a grant? I'm able-bodied.
All right. I found our chairman for that committee. Sounds great. Contact me. Let's get it set up. Let's do it.
Gotcha.
All right. Anybody else? don't know if you had your 3 minutes, but we'll last time. Okay. Yes.
No. 2 minutes.
Okay, that's good. We'll.
As far as the planning commission, you said that there's going to be a lot of changes in the township. Can you reflect on that somewhat? What kind of changes do you think that you want to make, or enlighten the rest of the township on what your changes might be?
Like I said, the blight is definitely one of those major things. Okay. You know, so I mean that's something obviously with the planning commission that we can help build some of those strategic plans through that planning commission as well. So as far as that, I mean, there's lots to work on. As far as the planning commission goes, we need to look at ways that we can build some capital fund campaigns. We need to look at extending some of our sewer and water services so that we can have opportunities. One of the major opportunities I think that we are missing right now is this corner right here. Now we have the restaurant that has opened up again. I've spoken with several people here on, let's look at some ways that we can get sewer and water so we can have a little bit more right on this corner that's busy with all the traffic that goes up and down to the fort every day. I think we're missing a great opportunity to have a little bit more business in Bedford Township that will be successful because of that traffic that we have here at this corner. And so our planning commission is something that has to sit down and open up our master plan and develop those strategic plans on how we make that happen. And so the planning commission is the ones that really do all of that. So that's a big part of it right now. So yes.
Are they looking at getting sewer and water out here? Is that what their planning commission is looking at doing?
Well, like I said, I've been looking at ways that we can start to expand just by little bits in the township. And so
that means residents pay from the road.
Well, that's,
we're going to run into a lot of opposition. Or if they want a fire station, they're paying for the roads, and now here comes sewer and water.
Yep. And this is where building up and developing further our master plan through the planning commission, that's where all of that lies. And so that's what we're looking at.
One more suggestion to you guys.
Okay.
Put on the website, welcome to Urbandale with a level park. When you welcome the pizza parlor in Urbandale?
I'm not sure.
On your website.
I'll double check. I don't believe I put Urbandale anywhere on there, but I will double check that. Absolutely. Yes, Mark.
Evan, can you tell me how the planning commission and the master plan would affect sewer and water? I guess I don't understand.
Yeah. I just described how our master plan and helping to build the capital campaigns is something that we will.
Capital campaign is something completely different than a master plan. A master plan is simply set zoning master, so it's saying that we see this corridor as commercial, which would allow it to, or as recently we just went back and did an overlay so that we allow commercial and residential voting between parks and residents. But the planning commission has nothing to do with sewer and water, nor never would. And the master plan has nothing to do with sewer and water.
Okay.
So I'm a little confused, but
okay.
Master, a lot of the things you're describing as a commission doing is not the thing that the planning commission really does.
Okay, thank you for that correction.
But and to get that sewer, just another thing, to get that sewer out here, even if you try to get it down West Michigan, take a vote of the residents of the township along with the residents of the city.
That's, yeah, I mean, there's no details that need to be really discussed on any of that right now.
You're talking many things that's got to happen before that's going to happen. Mm-hmm.
What's your plan or who's responsible or whatever for these two gas stations? I drive by them things 5-10 times a day.
Mm-hmm.
And they're abandoned.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what are we going to do about this township? The one, the roof leaks, the oil that comes out of the building when it rains, because there's so much oil in the back room of it.
Okay.
I'll look into that for you if you want me to.
Yeah.
I can't give you an honest answer right now, but I'll look into it and see what I have for you by next month's meeting, to be honest with you.
Sure. I know the one on Collier's been turned in, the EPA's been down there because when it rains,
yes.
They got 55 gallons of oil in it, comes out the back door. And
I don't think the EPA has released it yet, to my knowledge. And Logan's is owned by the state.
Yes.
What's that?
Logan's is owned by the state.
Yeah.
But Louis' old place isn't, right?
No, but EPA DEQ was in there when they had that last oil spill. Mm-hmm. And to my knowledge, they've not released it yet. So.
Mm-hmm. This seems like somebody could be responsible to clean it up, whether it's the state that owns it or whoever owns it.
Well, if I understand Logan's, is it not, Sally? Is that not cleaned up and been cleared?
I don't think they've cleared all the wells yet. They're still testing the wells across the street at Tuttle's place.
Okay.
And whatnot. So I think
it's still in the state's hands.
They're still testing.
And until it leaves there, you can't do anything with the building and stuff.
But the squeaky wheel gets the grease, so.
Absolutely.
There's a phone number that we can all start calling.
Yep.
So let's do it. It's just. You get tired of just seeing the same thing every day, every year. Mm-hmm.
Again, something for the chairperson, for the new blight committee. No, I'm just kidding. Anybody else? Or?
Yeah. One week for everybody first.
Sure, sir.
Good. Hey, I wasn't going to say anything tonight, but I introduced myself last month's meeting. My name is Peter Van Gotham. We own 15, 14 acres at the east end of Winwood, no, we're on Winwood, east end of Marie, east end of Wellington, all that, where you can see in the woods kind of getting pushed farther and farther back where all the logs are laying, those are mine. And the reason we built the house, moved into it 12 years ago, we petitioned the city, because I'm the city, to unannex us and annex into Bedford Township. The city, these guys are talking with the city people and I'm trying to keep on track. But since everybody brought up money tonight, I want to say we've lived there for 12 years. We drive a mile and a half from the end of my driveway. I have to go a mile and a half on Bedford Township Road before I get back into the city that I'm paying taxes to. It wasn't my plan. They did that. So for that 12 years, we paid in excess of $3,000 a year. We pay over $3,000 a year to City Bath Creek. In 12 years, I'm figuring that we would probably save a little money here, maybe about $2,500 for our property, roughly.
About.
Chief, mm-hmm. How many of these could I have bought for you in 12 years? What is it, $25,000, $30,000?
Yeah. It doesn't all come to us, but yeah. Right.
A very small portion of your taxes comes to the township. Yeah. A very small portion.
$200, the rest goes to the county and the schools.
The mills are broken down. I mean, it would all come through us, but a portion stays here, but still, yeah.
Not very much. I get to play with them, then I get to send it away.
The road I drive that mile and a half on each direction.
Oh, we'd definitely be getting that assessment off of
it. Just a real quick background, I lived in this area continuously for over 35 years. My wife, her mother died in a house up in the middle, behind Green.
Murray.
Your dad, mom, dad owned that. That's where I met her. She lived in like an apartment in the basement. Her sister still owns it and lives in it. My brother-in-law owned Logan's at one time. We're established already here. We're here. Nothing was moved except for the line on the map. And where my taxes go. Just want to throw that out there.
Thank you.
But the city that first released you, the Bedford will take you on.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else? Are we good? So we're good? All right. I don't think we need anything else from chair or any other elected people. I think we're good. All right. This meeting then is adjourned.
Access Vision, your voice, your community.